Hi, my name is Paweł Dygas. I'm a risk manager, and I would like to share with you a short tutorial on the EIOPA Climada app. This presentation is based on a presentation I held for Insurance and Pension Denmark. So at the end, you will also have an example from the Danish market, but the presentation will be mostly based on a Polish example. So why I thought to make an EIOPA Climada app tutorial? I have not found any tutorial on the web, and I'm a big fan of this solution because it gives a very simple tool which allows you to model catastrophic risks and climate change risks for your portfolio. As every natural hazard model, it consists of four elements. So you have hazard, vulnerability, exposure, and the financial component. And they are made simple, so you can really put your exposure in and use provided hazards and vulnerabilities to see what will be the financial impact on your portfolio. So let's start with a short information how to get the EIOPA Climada app. You go to the website of EIOPA, where you register yourself very simply with your first name, last name, your email address, and the name of the organization you are from. And then you receive an email in which a link to a web page is given from which you can download a zip file. You download the zip file, unzip it on your computer, and actually you can already start. You don't need to install anything. You are just using the Climada app icon in your folder. You have unzipped and you start your program. Important notice that if you are using this Climada app on your computer at work, it might be blocked by your firewalls. So it makes sense to contact your IT to support you in getting rid of the obstacles or to create a virtual environment where you can really connect to the web, because the Climada app provided by EIOPA connects during the usage with resources to get hazard and exposures from web pages outside of your organization. So we start by opening the folder which you downloaded and unzipped, and you start the application Climada app with this nice cloud in it. And the first view you get is very simple. You are getting an overview where you can input your exposure, hazard, the scenario you are picking, and the time horizon. The last element, you can also say what will be the annual growth of your portfolio, because we are also making here projections for the future as there are climate change scenarios in this app as well. So let's put an example for Poland. I'm using the average exposure for Poland. Then I pick the river flood, which is the biggest hazard in Poland. I use the historical scenario. Here I have just one option to pick from. The time horizon is from the year 2000. And just to make it simpler, I'm not assuming any annual growth. I just click run, wait a few seconds, actually often a few minutes, and I get a result, which I can analyze in either the app or also in some outputs I will show afterwards. So when we look in the app, here we have an overview of the exposure, where for Mazovia and Warsaw, we see the highest exposure. And then also in the Silesia area, we have quite a high exposure. The other parts are having lower exposure. This is the first tab. We can zoom in, zoom out. We can also have a look on the parts and see what is the exposure for the area of Warsaw. It's 262 billion. And we can move around and, of course, zoom in, zoom out to have a detailed look on parts of Poland we are interested in. The second part is the hazard module. Here we see the rivers in Poland, and we can have a look on different return periods. Right now, on the right side, you see the return period of 10 years was clicked, but we can move also to other return periods, and we can really also change it. Now you have a 200 years return period, and also for this hazard, you can have a look on intensity in a given square. Here I put a square within probably Warsaw, and we see that in one in 200 years, we have the water level of 4.38 meters. So this is the first option to analyze the portfolios. You are not putting your own portfolio, you are getting the average exposure, the overall exposure for Poland. You are also taking the hazard for Poland, as it's given by the modeling teams, which were included in this EIOPA Climada app. What is great is that you are not only assessing the risk in the app, but you can also get some details in reports created by the app. So you go to the folder you have unzipped, and there is a folder resources. In this folder, then you have a subfolder data. In this data, you will find reports, and there are always two types of reports which are created. One is a river, one is an Excel file, and the other is a PDF. So let's have a short view on the Excel. Here on the first page, we see a summary, what kind of model we have run. We see that we have run a model for Poland, for flood, for historical events. We see that we did not put any exposure growth, so it's zero. Then we can have a look on aggregated results. So we get the total exposure for Poland. We get the annual average loss of 629 million. And then we get also the losses for different return periods between 10 and 1,000. This is not the only result. We can also go on the NUTS level. So we see also for the counties, what are the exposures, and for each of the NUTS two areas, we also have the return period. So they are down below in the Excel. We can not only use the overall Polish exposures, but we can also introduce our own exposures. To do so, we go again to the folder we already know. In the subfolder data, there is another subfolder exposures, and here we can put our exposures in. We can do it on different levels, either on a country level or on the NUTS 2 level, which are these regions, or we can have a lat long exposure where we really put geographical location of our exposure. I will now put a latitude longitude exposure for Poland. I have put the biggest 24 cities, each of them with a value of 1 million. As you see here, this is a very simple exposure table. We do not distinguish between the line of business, which is inside these exposures. We do not distinguish between property and, for example, content or business interruption. So it's a very simple input. We are just putting in the exposure as it is without any additional details. So this is, of course, also a limitation of this model, that in the background, there's only one vulnerability curve for residential buildings in it. So we can put this exposure from Excel to our app. First, we clear our model here in the right up corner, and then we put the exposure from our Excel. So I have my file called exposure example cities with these Polish cities I have shown you. And then I put the river flood model for Poland, but this time I would like to have a look on the future projection where I will get a scenario with a high increase of temperature. So I take the RCP 8.5 and I take the time horizon for 2080, which I will compare with the historical scenario. Again, no annual growth to make it easier to compare. And then I run the model. Actually, this is how the screen looks like when the model is being run. It takes a while, as I said. And when we get the results, this time I will show you the other output, which is provided by Climada app from EIOPA. This is the report in PDF. Here again, on the first page, you see the details on what model you have run. I run the model for Poland, for river flood, and I have taken the scenario RCP 8.5. So I will analyze the strong increase of temperature and climate change. The time horizon is between 2070 and 2090. So the middle of this period is 2080. And again, the exposure was zero. Then I can look at the total exposure, 25 million euros, as I have put the biggest cities in Poland, each with 1 million. And then I get the baseline hazard. This means I take the model of historical floods for this portfolio. This is the upper table, and the lower table is the table where the model was run for in the RCP 8.5 for the year 2080. So I can see that the annual average loss in the historical scenario was 10,000 euros, and in the scenario of high temperature increase, it's nearly 21,000 euros on average. Here we see also how the return periods change. For example, the 200 years event in the historical scenario is 254,000, and in the climate change scenario in the year 2080 is 796,000. So we see nearly three times increase in the 200 years event. I get also a curve where I can have a look on the return periods for the current EP curve and the future aggregated EP curve. So the historical scenario above, the future scenario with climate change below. What is also interesting, not only the exposure can be put in from your portfolio, but you can also put your own hazard. For this, you need to have some deeper knowledge to create an HDF5 file. For this, you will probably need the full Climada model and some climate knowledge to do so. But there are also lots of resources available on the internet from research institutes. So here, just to show, I put a river flood model for Poland for the year 2020. And I can upload an exposure. Here I put an exposure in Denmark, just to show that we have also other countries available. So now I'm showing an exposure in Denmark, a hazard also for Denmark will be now loaded in. I found on a research institute, Swiss research institute, a windstorm model for Denmark, which I will upload. And here I can run the model and at the end see the storm Europe risk analysis for Denmark in 2014, a historical scenario. And I can analyze the risk for the headquarters of Insurance and Pension Denmark, for which the presentation was done, on which the current presentation you are watching is based. So at the end, I would like to share with you some links which might be helpful. So we have a user manual provided by EIOPA. We have Climada documentation. There is also a working group page from ETH Zurich. And I also put a link on example of the hazard file database from which, for example, I took the historical windstorm model for Denmark. But there are also plenty of other countries available. If you would have any questions or you would like to exchange views, you can contact me either via email or on my LinkedIn profile. I hope you liked this short tutorial on EIOPA Climada app. I wish you great usage of this tool and looking forward to get some comments how the application in your case looked like.